please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Let's now cut across to Ritu Singh, who's in conversation with PK Gupta, the SBI MD, on the stressed power assets.
So, you know, we understand there are 7 to 8 power assets that SBI was trying to work with to resolve outside a similar amount of non-power assets. What is the status on those now, sir, for the Feb 12 circular?
See, the Samadhan scheme, we were working on 11 assets. Yeah. Okay, so out of those 11, 4 we found could not be resolved.
Yeah.
So they have been going to NCLT.
Yeah.
So the rest of the 7, we are still trying to work out.
Yeah.
We have time up to the 11th of September.
Hmm.
So we'll see that if some of them can get implemented. We'll wait for the outcome of the meeting today in Delhi and let us see how it goes.
So when you say you have time till 7, the deadline has ended. This time is only to refer cases to NCLT.
Yeah. No, in some of these cases, the approvals are already in place. There is a 15 days time to implement the resolution. So that is what we are trying to do.
Okay, sir, in the non-power sector, are you hopeful of closing some of these cases before the 7th September end of deadline?
I don't think there are too many in the non-power, actually. So
okay.
We are generally looking at the power sector. So, I mean, if we are able to implement, we should be able to do that. So as far as the impact on the bank's balance sheet is concerned, we have already held enough provisions against all of them. So even if they go to NCLT, it doesn't really affect the bank much.
But sir, generally, what is the level of provision on these accounts that have been impacted by the Feb 12 circular?
No, overall provision coverage ratio, if you see, of the bank, we are already at around 63%.
Okay,
so we do have enough provisions, generally around 50% range for most of these assets.
So just one last question, you know, the banks are also making representations in Delhi today in that meeting on the power sector. What sort of an outcome are you expecting? What will the bankers' pitch be?
No, I think from the bankers' point of view, quite a few of these. I think one concern is about the FSAs and the PPAs that have already been there.
Yeah.
So the concern has been is that if they go to the NCLT, they should not get annulled actually. Okay, can we, you know, NCLT as it is should be seen as more of a resolution mechanism than recovery. So if you accept that anything which goes to NCLT is for the purpose of resolution and these PPAs and FSAs need not be cancelled, so that is one, I think, which the banks would probably be hoping for. And in some of the cases, the resolutions are probably nearing implementation. So if the banks can get a little bit more time, so we can implement those resolutions.